I am Matthew from Maltby.
I am Lee from Rotherham.
I am Matt from Exborough.
I'm Oliver from Sheffield.
I'm Jordan from Newbury.
We are Bring Me the Horizon.
Well, Mantra came quite late in the recording process. We'd already got a bunch of songs that we were quite excited about, but we didn't have anything. We were also really scared to show people. None of the songs felt like right as the first one back because they were all so different to each other and from the last record that we still didn't feel like we had a song that we could show first. And that's kind of how Mantra was born. We're like, if we were going to take what we did from the last record and do it and add new stuff to it, what would it sound like? And Mantra were kind of born out of that idea, like, this is the first song back. So it was always intended, whatever it ended up like, to be the first song back. We kind of decided before we'd even finished it. It just felt like it bridged the gap between what we'd done on the last few records and then where we were going with the new sound and elements of what to expect. And also that you can't really, not to expect the last record, basically.
Yeah, chuffed to pieces, yeah. I think it was an overall pretty positive reception for the song when we first dropped it. Yeah, so like I always said, it's not too far removed from what we've done before, you know what I mean? So it was a nice song to ease us in to the new album.
I think we'd be pretty mind-blown, to be honest, because when we started the band, we didn't take it very seriously in respect to, like, we didn't have a goal or a plan. You know, we never dreamed of, like, going and playing arenas or even really doing any of the stuff that we've managed to do over the, like, 14-year span of our band. So, yeah, I think we'd be quite mind-blown. I think we'd be stoked because even when we were writing heavier music, we all had a love for the kind of music that we write now. So I just don't think we'd be able to believe it because most of us, like Bar, like Lee, who could, you know, went to college to study music and could play guitar well, we all self-taught, like, on our instruments or whatever, like, so I just don't think we'd understand even what we are doing right now, to be honest.
I guess mostly it's not really rock music, to be honest. We listen to a lot of other stuff, so I think the stuff that, like, makes us excited and gives us inspiration is usually not like rock bands. We listen to a lot of, like, electronic music, and we listen to a lot of old stuff as well, or at least stuff from, like, when we were growing up a lot when we're writing. So yeah, I can't probably think of one band who I hear and, like, feel inspired, excited by at the moment. But yeah, I think it works better for us to take that inspiration and excitement from other genres, because it kind of then feeds into our music and makes it weirder and a bit more different. So that's how I feel about that.
I think we're quite inspired by there's bands that we don't necessarily listen to, which might sound weird, but that inspire us in how they did what they did. Bands like Nine Inch Nails or like Radiohead or things like that, where we're inspired by bands that carve out their own identity and push on and always surprise people and, you know, generate a new sound by taking elements from different places and stuff. And I mean, to echo what Jordan says, we don't listen to rock music at all, in all honesty. Like, for the lack of anything interesting coming out, there hasn't been like an icon in rock for 20-30 years. Do you know what I mean? When you think of like legends, it's all people that are old or dead in rock music. You know what I mean? It's, you got Metallica and, you know, Ozzy Osbourne and U2 and things like that. But like in every other genre of music, there's like icons are still being made. You know, there's people who are like the biggest thing in the world right now that have been out, not in rock music. So it's kind of hard to be inspired by the genre right now. So that's kind of what draws our inspiration, is people that are making their own identity. And a lot of time it don't come from rock music, so that's why the albums ended up sounding quite different. It deals like a lot about love, like between the last record and this record. I was married and I found out my partner was having an affair, got divorced, met someone else quite soon after, fell in love with that person, got married again. So in the like span of like a year and a half, 2 years, like I've been on this really fast version of something that usually spans over maybe like 5, 6, whatever years. So it's been like almost like a front seat of like just seeing how crazy and powerful something like love can be, like going through all the emotions so quick, kind of like made it all seem like it was quite reflective, because a lot of things like that don't usually happen in that way. And I'm quite aware of how crazy it was, but it was happening. So I was just going with it and being like, well, it's happening. But at the same time, it was like things like that are usually so drawn out that you don't really realize how crazy things are, that you're like, you're going to spend the rest of your life with someone, or in your head, the next day you never want to see that person ever again. It's just crazy how powerful it can be, but how violently it can change and stuff like that, and how it can change. I mean, that's kind of what Mantra was about to start with, is like the idea of like a relationship being like starting a cult, because you have to hand over basically your trust and your faith and everything in this one person. People move countries to go and live in a different country. They lose all the friends. They have to make new ones. They might have to lose a job. You know, it's such a powerful thing that people literally will take such a mad leap of faith into the unknown. It's the only thing powerful enough in the world to make people make these kind of decisions. So, yeah, in this very short span of time, I went through all this. It basically been my life for the last 2 years. So I tried to shy away from writing about it. Like, I didn't really want to write about my ex and stuff like that, because I didn't want to seem like I were dwelling on a situation where I'm happy, I'm glad it happened. So to sing about it almost felt like it was something I was still upset about, but that really wasn't it. You know, like, it was really more just like drawing from things that happened, because I found myself trying to write about other things and it just didn't feel real or interesting or like I had much to say. But this journey that I've been on is just, it was just quite interesting. Like, whoa, everything changes in the blink of an eye, and it affects so much parts of your life that it was just kind of like, it was just thriving with topics to talk about and sing about. So it's quite a easy concept to write about for an album. In terms of like the nihilistic stuff, that's just something I guess my song, like my lyrics and stuff, always have that element to it, because it's just, I wouldn't call myself a nihilist, but I definitely connect with when people describe what nihilism is. Like, I definitely feel that on a regular basis, like sometimes just that kind of like, what's the point in living kind of feeling. And it's, for me, I like it in the sense that it's like, sometimes it can feel like crushingly depressing, like, why do I bother, what is the point? And sometimes it can feel so freeing, in the respect that like, nothing, the point is there's no point or whatever, you know what I mean? And it's quite like, sometimes we worry about stuff too much, or sometimes life gets so like overpowering and you think it don't actually matter, nothing really matters. So it's just a topic that I always like to sing about, so there's definitely some elements of and vibe of that in there. It's not all bad. I think it's quite a cool emotion, and we try and capture that kind of emotion with the music as well.
I think the first one we got on there was Roselle. Was it the first one? When it just came about a demo we had, and it sounded like it almost sounded like it was beatboxing, you know what I mean? And then I think Jordan had this bonkers idea of actually getting Roselle on the record. And he was keen. He was good. He did a record with Bjork and Mike Patton before.
He used to be in The Roots.
Yeah.
He used to be in The Roots.
And he's just been around for a while. We were saying earlier, it used to be like when you were a kid and you first like started discovering shit on the internet, he was like almost viral, one of his videos. And it was just, so we just known him from just being mental at beatboxing, you know what I mean? And then, so we reached out to him and he was keen, and he's on there. Sounds good.
There's Grimes. Grimes is like a avant-garde pop artist, kind of like, it's more artistic-y kind of pop, basically. And she's someone that I've liked for ages. Like, I've always been a fan of her work and like her album Art Angels, which quite like critically like well received, and like yeah, she's someone who's just quite, she produces all her own music and she does all her own videos, and she's just one of them people that's really like inspiring as an artist. And I think Matt saw in an interview she did for like Enemy in England or something, when they asked her like what band she's into or what music she listened to, and she said, oh, I really like British bands like Brim and Horizon. So we were just like, that'd be, when we started thinking about guests, we just thought that'd be someone that would be sick to approach, and we wasn't sure if, we didn't know how much she meant that, because we just didn't know. And apparently she heard the song, and she said after like 15 seconds that she was just like, definitely, I'm up for this. This is amazing. So she was really, really involved with the song. Like, she definitely, it's got her touch throughout. Like, she didn't write any of it, but she added her own sounds and ideas to the song, and it just, it's my favorite song on the track, on the album, sorry. Just because I liked it anyway, but bringing her in really made it into something like that we've never done before.
Danny Filth from Cradle of Filth is the other guest, and he's on a track called Wonderful Life. How did that one come about? That was kind of, with the middle eight of it's kind of got this like, of the song's kind of got this like, almost like party, like spooky goth vibe. It's kind of hard to explain, but, and then Ollie just had the idea of, well, why don't we get Danny Filth from Cradle of Filth on it? And that was basically, I mean, there was no real reasoning for it. It was just a crazy idea, wasn't it? I think we thought it'd be cool to have a little, almost like a little throwback reference to have someone from that world on there. And he's a kind of cool character. And yeah, I guess that was where it came about, kind of thing.
It's someone we'd have loved to have on our album like 10 years ago that would have never done it back then. So it's, and it, like Jordan says, it's kind of in touch with our roots. Like we had that, obviously, it's like Grimes, who's like from one world, Rizal's from another world, and we wanted someone from our world, but not just like one of our contemporaries. We wanted someone that like represented like heavy rock music. Yeah, well, Nihilist Blues is a song that's on our album coming up, and I think that's my favourite song we've ever wrote. I really love it, so yeah.
The last song on new CD called, I Don't Know What To Say? That's probably one of my favourites. No one's heard it yet, but it's a good track, so that one.
I'm going to go on an old one from Suicide Season, Death Breath. For some reason I always like that track. I think it's just because lyrics, it really captured what we were all about at that point in time, you know what I mean? Just going out and just having a good time, basically. And yeah, I always enjoyed that song, so
I'm gonna go for a new one called Why You Gotta Kick Me When I'm Down. It's probably like the most, it's just a weird fusion of genres, and I really like it when we do that. And I think it's just probably was one of the most unusual combination. It just really feels like it's fused really well. So just from a personal level, I like the music and the instrumentation. I love the lyrics. It's just a really weird, unusual song. It doesn't sound like anyone to me whatsoever, and I like that as well. So it's quite original sounding song.
I'm gonna go for a song called Heavy Metal on the new CD. I think it's cool. I like the lyrics in it, because it's kind of a song that we've never done before. It's always kind of like breaking the fourth wall in a way, and it's kind of like speaking from like a band's perspective of putting like a new song out there, you know what I mean? And like all the fears and stuff that you have with like putting like art on display, you know what I mean? You never know. You never know whether it's going to be like received well or not, and it's like the most anxious time, you know. And I don't know, I guess it's like a band's song in a way.